Hello. On this video, I'm gonna show you how to use Visual Studio 2015 to create a web page using web forms and doing a simple hello world. So, new project. I want a C# web application. Hello world. Click OK. I'm gonna create a empty project. Because this video is for total beginners, I'm going to start with an empty project, but you could start with web forms or even MVC, and also you could create your folders. But for learning purpose, for total beginners, I'm going to create a empty project. Click OK. If you look right here on the top right on the Solution Explorer, you're going to notice that Visual Studio create a lot of files and folders for you. If you had created this project as an MVC or as a web form with the folders, there'll be a lot more, really a lot more files and folders here. Now I did as an empty project, so those files will not be confusing for you. So let's create the first file. I'm gonna right click and add a web form. If the web form is not here, then click new item. And then you can choose the new item right here. I'm going to name index.aspx. Then click on add. And Visual Studio created this for us. So there is an index file, aspx, and then index.aspx.cs, and then the designer.cs. For now, we're just concerned about two files. The index.aspx and the index.aspx.cs. So right here on the index.aspx, between the div, I'm gonna put a header one, and I'm gonna type hello world. Start without debugging. Visual Studio, which has a web server built in, will start serving the pages. So you do not need to actually have a web server somewhere to test it. You can test on your own computer. The URL is localhost. There's a port here, 8229, and then the name of our page. So the web server from Visual Studio is now running. And that's your first hello world. But this hello world here is a straight HTML code. Let's do the same thing, but coming from the server side. For that, I'm going to remove the hello world here. And then I'm going to create a text box. So it's ASP text box. The ID is going to be text box message. And then it's very important now, run at server. If you don't put run at server, then the code behind cannot see this text box. So now let's go to the index.aspx.cs file. You can see there's one function, and this function here runs whenever the page loads. So whenever the page loads, I want a message to display in the text box. So text box message dot text equals hello world. And now if I run this program, there's a hello world right there on a text box. Now let's go a little further. Let's put the current time on this text box. So going back to the code behind, which is the CS file, instead of putting the text message now, I want to get the current time. And the current time is daytime equals daytime.now. So this class here is a C# class that controls time for us, which is great. So instead of putting hello world now, I want to put now dot toString, and now we run the website. And that shows me the current time. That's very easy. But then the next question is, what if I want the time to update on a click? Well, now we need to create a button right here. The button will be the ASP button. The text will be get time. Right here on the bottom, there are three options. One is design, split, and source. I'm looking at the source now, but I can look in the split. And once I click on the split, half of the screen will be the code, and the bottom of the screen is going to be something that will look like your web page. And interesting enough, we have an error right here. And it shows an error here because the run at server is not there. Remember, if run at server is not there, then the back code can't see it. So let's put the run at server there. And now everything is happy. If you want, you can put the entire screen as your design. So I'm gonna click now on the design on the bottom. And now everything here looks similar to what your page will be. Now on here on the design, if you click on toolbox, by the way, if you don't see the toolbox here, you can go to view and toolbox. You will see a lot of items, and you can just drag and drop these items right here. For example, the button, and that will create a button for you. And if you go back to your source, you can see this is the button created for you. I'm going to delete this because I don't need it. And now I want the time to display on this text box whenever I click this button here. So when I click the button, I want this click to call a function on the CSS file. So I'm going to say onClick, then it's going to do something for us. And I want to create a new event. And this will create a function for us right here in the back. So when I click that button, this function gets called. And I want this function to display the date time again. So I'm just going to copy these two lines here, and I'm going to paste right here. Now, let's run it again. And every time I click get time, this time here gets updated. And that's all for this video. This is very easy, and you can do it.